See, waiting is something everybody has to do. If a woman has conceived a baby, she has to wait for 9 months for the baby to come out. A farmer has sown a seed, he has to wait for the seed to grow into a plant. An horticulturist has planted a fruit tree. He cannot say, tomorrow I want fruit. You have to wait till the fruit comes. Life teaches you in many ways that you have to wait. You have written an exam. You can't say, I want to know the result today. You have to wait for the result to come. Correct? Waiting is a virtue. Nature compels you to wait. Now, what is our tendency? Our mind wants everything right away. We want everything quick fix. We want results right away. This restlessness makes us miserable and we make others miserable at home. Now, this is the time when we are all locked in the house around the globe. We have to learn how to wait. Now, waiting can cause frustration. But the same waiting, we can turn it into meditative experience. Then you know, you become more creative, become more alert. If you don't, then you become emotional, you get upset, you get agitated, and you make a mess of the whole situation, whole time. Let us practice waiting. The world is not going to fall on your head. We are in such a big hurry, everything we want quick, right away. Where are you going? You know, this lockdown is going to help you to cool down, calm down. Sit back and think about your own life. We are busy in getting the accessories to life, not really putting attention on life itself, taking care of life itself. We are taking care of our garment, but we are not taking care of our skin. We are taking care of our gadi, our car, but not taking care of our body. Isn't it? So in the rat race of life, we have forgot the center core of existence, that is life itself. Now is the time that we need to sit back and think and learn to have patience. And patience develops. I mean, just imagine someone is so impatient. How do you like to be with them? Suppose you are expected to deliver something. And the person who is on the receiving end is so impatient. How do you like that? Huh? Suppose you are preparing some nice dishes at home. You are making pudding at home. And the children are so impatient, they want it right away. You can't give them half-baked things, right? I would like you all to do an experiment at home. You know what? Anyone wants anything, make them wait for 5 minutes, 10 minutes. See, if you have to go to bathroom, if you have to use washroom, and washroom is busy with somebody else there, you have to wait. Nature makes you wait. Right? Of course, there is a limit for waiting. It is not complacent. It's not being lethargic. Patience is not lethargy. We should not mistake. Impatience and restlessness is not efficiency. So let us ponder on this. Let us learn to wait. There is a beautiful story. Rishi Narada was a globetrotter. And sage Narada was known to everybody, and he was supposed to know what's going to happen in the future also. When he was walking, and he found under a tree, a sage was sitting and meditating. And he went to the sage and asked him, what is it you want? What are you doing? He said, I am meditating. I want enlightenment. So Narada said, good luck. Then he kept moving, and the sage said, by the way, since you have come, I would like to ask you, if you know, you tell me how many more days will it take for me to get enlightened? So Rishi Narada looked at him. He said, not in this lifetime, you will have to take another 3 lifetimes to get enlightened. That sadhak, that gentleman got so angry. He threw his mala, he threw his rosaries and said, enough is enough. I have done all my life this tapasya. I have done all my life this penance. No more. Three more life, no way, he said. Well, Rishi said, well, I can't say anything more. Bye. And he left. When the Rishi, Narada, went a little further, he found another young boy who was sitting and meditating. He asked him, what do you want? The young boy said, I want nothing, but now that you are asking, you tell me when I will get enlightened. So Rishi Narada looked at him and looked at the tree that was behind him, told him, you may have to take that many lifetimes as many leaves are there in the tree. The boy was overjoyed. He said, only one tree in this planet? There are so many trees, billions of trees. I am done. It's done. He said, he started dancing. He was overjoyed, saying, only this much? This is very easy. I will do that. You know, this resolution to take things with a good spirit, with a positive spirit, is very necessary. When we are frustrated, when we are agitated, waiting is impossible. But when we are calm, when we are serene, we are ready to wait. We have patience. Patience is a virtue. And when you embrace waiting, either with challenge or with serenity and meditation, you can increase your patience.